CMA Instrumentalist of the Year Award. I started saying male vocalist. Maybe he'll sing. Maybe he'll burst into song. Anyway, he's doing part of a 30-minute piece, believe it or not, called Strings and Threads. Please welcome Mark O'Connor.
Yeah.
You made an interesting observation about him while he was standing over there.
Well, yeah,
right?
I said, you remember before we were saying that you kind of look like a gangster with those shoes there. I said, you're probably the only gangster who really has a violin in the violin case.
Yeah,
with that machine gun there.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, that was part of a 30-minute piece you were telling me. This is a little excerpt of it. Mm-hmm. How do you remember a 30-minute piece like that? I mean, could you mess up, nobody'd know, wouldn't
you? No, yeah, that's true, especially when you're playing by yourself and and nobody's following you or trying to follow you. But it's something, it's a little different when you write it, you know, it's so close to you that once you have the definitive version of it, then it's easy to remember.
Well, it's part of a play at the Tennessee Performing Arts Center you're involved in. Have you done that sort of thing before?
No, this is the first time, and the Metro Arts Council here gave me this opportunity to write for the dance theater, and we premiered it at our Summer Lights Festival here last summer.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be doing it again next weekend, December 2nd and 3rd, at Tennessee Performing Arts Center.
All right.
People want to see the whole 30 minutes.
Yes, with choreography as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, you also were nominated this year for a CMA Award, Instrumentalist of the Year.
Yeah.
And this is the third year in the row?
Third year. Yeah. And great players, you know, like Chet Atkins always win, and Johnny Gimble. But, boy, to be nominated with, you know, right under those people like that is really amazing.
Especially in this town.
Yeah,
oh,
no
yeah.
kidding. Well, there's a special presentation you made, I think it's to the Hall of Fame up here, right? Of a fiddle that you had been playing since you were, what, that high?
Yeah.
How old were you when you first started using the fiddle? We're going to see here in a minute.
13 years old, I acquired it, and it was a white fiddle that mm-hmm. I started playing through the championships, and I had won the Grand National Fiddle Championship.
Now, this is on the Opry, right?
That is a spot on the Opry, that Roica.
Oh, and look at that.
It's Junior.
Little Mark.
Now, look at the fiddle. You'll see some autographs on there. Whose autographs are those?
It was all the heroes of my youth and growing up playing and listening to these people. That's the when I won the award here at the Grand Masters Fiddle Championships, and Roy Guff and Porter Wagner were giving up me mm-hmm. out the first place.
Well, so you give up the fiddle. I guess you go visit it at the museum, right?
Yeah. I was really tickled that they wanted it. And they told me that they're going to put it on a motor, and it will be twirling around inside a case so you can see all the signatures from all the famous fiddle players.
I also understand you have a project with Voice of America coming up.
Yeah, I help these people. They're Vietnam vets that put this album together, and it's the proceeds from this album are going to help descendants of veterans that were killed.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a very great project, great music. A lot of people from Nashville helped out on the project, and I guess you can call here to find out more information.
Sure. Yeah, we've got all the information if you'd like to give us a call about the Bobby Ross album, The Voice of America. It's a great way to help out the Vietnam vets.
Yeah.
Good to see you involved in that. I noticed over here, before you started playing, you were doing like this, like a baseball pitcher.
Yeah.
Do you have to have warm fingers in order to really go quick?
Yeah, I mean, it's been said that in cold climates, you know, 15 minutes of practice or running your hands under cold or hot water is about equal.
All right, I want you to pick up the fiddle here before we take a break. I want you to play that thing. I want the fastest thing you know on that fiddle.
Ooh.
And we'll go out with it. Okay. That's pretty fast, isn't it? Folks, how about it from Mark O'Connor? Mark, thanks for being our guest. We'll be back. Later on in the show, Peter Lawford's widow talks about her memories of it. We'll be back.
If you're going to be in the Nashville area...